shot shells are loaded into the magazine through the bottom of the receiver. The compressed magazine spring keeps tension on the shells. Pressing the action bar lock allows the fore-end to be pulled to the rear. As it comes back, a shell is fed into the receiver. Pushing forward on the fore-end lifts the shell, and the bolt guides it into the chamber. As the fore-end moves back, a cutout on the bottom of the slide engages the carrier dog. As the slide moves forward, downward force is put on the carrier, acting as a lever to lift the shell up. The left and right latches allow shells into the receiver under the control of the fore-end tube assembly. Notches on the assembly move the latches in and out at specific times. The left latch holds the shell until the fore-end is almost fully rearward. After the first shell advances into the receiver, the right latch catches the next shell. As the fore-end is pushed forward, the first shell is moved into the chamber and the left latch assumes control of the next shell. When the bolt makes contact with the breech face, the slide pushes up on the locking block, locking it into the barrel. With the safety in the off position, the trigger is free to move. Pulling the trigger rotates the sear, which releases the hammer. The hammer strikes the firing pin, causing it to travel forward and impact the shell primer. The inside of a shot shell contains a primer, powder charge, a wad, and shot or a slug. Inside the primer is a primer cup, priming compound, and an anvil. As these are struck by the firing pin, a chain reaction ignites the powder charge inside the shell, and the wad is propelled down the barrel. Just after leaving the barrel, the wad opens so the shot can spread. The extractor grips the rim of the spent shell case. As the fore-end is pulled to the rear, the bolt is unlocked and the case is extracted from the chamber. The bolt continues to the rear and the ejector kicks out the empty case from the receiver. As the bolt comes back, the hammer is reset and held back by the sear. When the fore-end is fully forward, the action bar lock lowers the connector, again, allowing control of the sear with a pull of the trigger.